Hi, this is Mark from M Solar Power in Cape Town, South Africa, and I'd like to welcome you to the first in this video series. The title of the video series is My Goal is Zero. My goal is zero electricity spend with Eskom for the year and a zero power interruptions as we've been having a lot of load shedding here in South Africa. So, as part of the process, I'm going to take you through the technology that I have installed, the City of Cape Town's framework of how the feed-in tariff works, and my general experience on a day-to-day basis with different types of weather and different types of power usage in our home. I have a 10 kilowatt three-phase hybrid installed from Solar X Power with 25.2 kilowatt hours of lithium ion storage. And typically, without solar power, my electricity spend would be around 3,500-4,000 rand a month. And my goal really is to generate sufficient excess power in the summer months to offset the power imports that my home will need in Cape Town solar winter, which is typically between the 15th of June and the 15th of September. So that being said, let's dive straight into it and just have a look at my home today. I'm filming this on the 1st of February around midday, and this graph is showing my power usage for the day. So if I have a look at it, you can see if I put my cursor here, this is at 12:05 in the morning in the AM, and this is just after 12 here now in the middle of the day. So the graph may look a little bit confusing, but if I just take away the actual different items, and if I just show you that we are have been having a cloudy weather here in Cape Town for yesterday and today. And here you can see at around 6 o'clock in the morning, I started generating solar power, and you can see the sun came out a little bit earlier and dipped off as the clouds increased. And now we're experiencing full sunshine around the middle of the day. I've got 12 kilowatts of glass-on-glass bifacial solar panel on a ground mount installed in my garden. As of a thatched roof, I can't install any panels on my roof. And this then is just the solar production for today. But what helps here is we can actually see the load power in my home. The load is shown in purple, the purple being my power usage. And you can see my heat pump turning on this morning to heat up my morning water for my shower, because yesterday was overcast. And this, in essence, is going to show the grid power usage. And the whole goal of zero is for your home to stay above the line, above the north line, meaning my power generation. And so this being stored solar power from yesterday in battery. With my home phasing below the line at 1:30 in the morning, you can see the red line going down below, meaning grid power. And as the solar power kicked in for the day, you can see my home phasing above the line with the solar generation now running greater than what my actual home's consumption is. And that excess solar power is being stored in my battery for this evening cycle. Typically, during the summer months, we don't normally go below the line overnight. And you can see yesterday being a partly overcast day, shown by the spikiness of my solar output graph. And if we have a look at a typical Cape Town day, just give it a second to refresh. Typically, during summer months, we have a smoother parabolic curve, as shown on this curve. Here you can see it was partly cloudy in the morning, with basically my home's load power being totally from battery power overnight, with no grid power being drawn overnight. But here you can see shown in red, on a sunny day, we're feeding in power. In other words, red is normally below the line. And here you can see I'm basically feeding in excess power into the grid. And that basically is easy to see. If we take away the PV power, you can see no grid power, the slight little bit of grid power just maintaining my connection to the grid, and the feed in of my excess power during the day. And the idea here really is that I've oversized my solar system, so I'm producing a lot more power than I actually need now. And as I mentioned, the purpose of this power is to supplement my power usage in the middle of the solar winter for Cape Town. So what you can see here on the right, if I just zoom into the screen, is a picture of my power usage today. So far today, I have generated 46% of my power needs and imported 53% of my power. I was at 1:30 this morning, my batteries ran out and I needed to import power from the grid. So that being said, let's just have a look at how my home did for the month of January. And so the one was a day view. This is now a monthly view. So you can see during January, we imported 77 kilowatt hours, or 6% or 6.5% of my home's energy needs, and self-consumed 48% of our generation, 1,100 kilowatt hours. And we exported 1,178 kilowatt hours onto the grid for the month of January. So what I plan to do in this series is just to go through this type of detail in a much greater depth on a day-to-day basis, bring out the news and of how this is actually working for me, and basically run this video series up till December the 31st and see if I manage to achieve my goal being zero power import from the grid over a year, and zero power interruptions. So thanks for tuning in, and I look forward to sharing all of my experiences with you as the year progresses.